line drive, base hit. Murray coming around third.
Throw the puppy out.
What an animal.
And he's out.
Out?
Who's out?
What?
We are.
Out of what?
Of
beer.
Oh, don't run out of beer. Come into an AM/PM mini market and stock up on hams. The suitcase of 24 cans is just $5.99.
Rex, yo, where's the beer? Go to AM/PM and pick some up, would you?
Go for a walk
and bring in the paper.
Stock up for less at AM/PM.
Terrorism grips the world. Unexplained disasters occur. No sane person would ever connect these events. That's what they're counting on. There are no accidents. This is war. War of the Worlds.
Every Sunday night at 8 on KPTV 12.
I've got to apologize for Billy Jack Haynes' actions up here. This entire place is absolutely stunned. Sir, I saw you down there. You were going absolutely crazy. What's your name, sir?
Rich.
Rich?
Rich.
Rich, and you've been a fan, probably. I know you've been a fan here for a long time, and I'm sure you've been a fan of Billy Jack Haynes for a long time.
Since I was young.
I don't know what has happened. What do you feel about this?
I don't know. I just kind of shocked at how he changed his attitude. You know, I've liked him for a long time. Just scared, you know, kind of startled the crowd.
What, you know, he was saying, he's saying some horrible things now all of a sudden about Oregonians. What do you think about that?
I'm not really sure why, you know, it's just like, why would somebody change like this for no reason, you know?
How do you feel about Oregon?
I don't look at him in the same way as I used to, just because of the way he treated everybody and acted towards the other wrestlers and everybody around.
Well, you saw what happened out there in the ring. I mean, he thought he was attacked by Larry Oliver. He was not attacked by it.
No, it was the other guy. He just kind of went crazy. He lost it.
Okay, Rich, I didn't mean to... to shock you up here, but I was in a state of shock myself. Rich, thank you very much for coming up here and just sharing your thoughts about Billy Jack Haynes. Man, actually, what we need to do right now is get on with our drawing for our tournament.
Chris, I can't believe you just had that idiot up here talking. I'm going to tell you something. I don't care about Oregon, but I promise you one thing, buddy. I'm the happiest man in the building tonight because you see what Billy Jack did to them Olivers? It's been a long time coming, boy. But you know something, Rip Oliver? You should have never brought that snot-nosed punk and tried to make him a wrestler. Now, this is a man's sport, brother. And when it gets too hot, you can't stand it. Get out of the kitchen, Jack. That's what just happened right there. And I'm proud of Billy Jack Haynes, and I'm proud of the way he feels about Oregon. I'll tell you what, Coss, I'm ready to make my selection here. But you know something? I've held that Northwest heavyweight title a lot of times. And brother, I was proud to have it around my waist because Oregon finally had somebody to be proud of in their state. And I'll tell you what, brother, I'm going to make my choice. I'm going to the tournament, and I'm coming out, and I'm going to be the winner. Once and for all, and I ain't never let nobody take that belt away from me. Billy Jack, that's something, ain't it? Equalizer, wait a minute.
He's got the equalizer.
No. I don't want this here. Hey, I'm not wrestling equalizer. He's part of the wrecking crew. Man, he's 6'5". He weighs 300 pounds. I'll tell you one thing, I'm not taking that one. Whatever I got to do, I'll wrestle somebody else. I'm not wrestling the equalizer. No way.
He drew the equalizer. If you want that belt. Oh, man.
Your next
event
of the evening.
This is something else.
Will be one.
The grappler.
Best two out of three falls or to a TV time
the
limit.
Equalizer.
Introducing in the ring at this time, the team of Turncoat Al Madril. And the New Jersey stud and TV champion, the New Jersey stud, Scotty the Body.
Yeah.
their opponents. The team and Pacific Northwest Tag Team Champions, ladies and gentlemen, the Beetlejuicers. Barry Owens, you're standing right here. Juicers, if you're so tough and you think you're the greatest team in the world, why don't you put those belts up right now? Right now! Let's see what kind of men you really are. What do you think, Barry Owens?
You know? Yeah? Well, you know, I believe that any team can get beat on any given night, Madril. If you want the titles on the line, we'll put the titles on the line. But it's 2 out of 3 falls, man. 2 out of 3 falls.
What? They're going to put the titles
okay,
on the...
This will be the best 2 out of 3 falls to a TV time limit for the Pacific Northwest Tag Team Championship.
My goodness, we're having things change. This is the night of shockwaves. In the crow's nest with us right now is Jonathan Holliday. Jonathan.
The people are excited in the Northwest, and I can't. I'm right up there with them on top of cloud nine. Did you just see what Billy Jack did to that snot-nosed punk, Larry Harvey? Just knocked him in the next week. I hope that kid goes to the hospital and gets himself a room to rent for the year, because I'll tell you what, I predicted big things for him, and what he got was a big knock on the head, and I hope he stays in there for good.
Oh, I tell you, you're about as disgusting as Billy Jack Haynes
is
right now.
Hey, I'd like to turn Billy Jack, you know what? Easter Sunday's tomorrow, and I can see now Billy Jack will be out helping all the kids pick up their Easter eggs and sticking them down their throat for them.
Oh, God. I never thought I'd ever see this here or anywhere.
That's what you get for thinking.
I mean, Billy Jack Haynes has turned against all of us. He's turned against his fans,
and you know what? He's
state.
Just like any other American. He's just like me, you know. We're on rush hour every day driving down I-5. We'll see a bunch of Oregonians out there behind the wheel picking their nose and chewing it. And we don't like to see. That's why they're so
come
fast.
Come on, Jonathan Holliday. You see that move by Little Beetlejuice? Wow, man, I tell you.
He would have never got that on Billy Jack or me, that's for sure.
He rocked and rolled Al Madril right out of the ring. But, Madril is complaining.
Oh, I think he wants to challenge me. Let me tell you something, Juice. You're lucky I got a broken. Did you see that?
Hey, I just got the word that they have taken Rip Oliver to the hospital. They've taken him to the hospital. You saw what Billy Jack Haynes did to the man up here. And I'm telling you, I wish Billy Jack Haynes... Oh, man, look at that.
Now, let's see. Did you see the move Al Madril just did to Beetlejuice? I'll bet you right now Beetlejuice has got the wind knocked out of him, and it's hard for him to think. Beetlejuice is history.
I hope Billy Jack Haynes has a chance to see the tape of tonight's pro wrestling matches here at the House of Action, because he's going to see that he was not attacked by Larry Oliver or Rip Oliver, anybody, that he was attacked by the Wrecking Crew.
Let me explain the facts of life to you, Mr. Koss. Billy Jack could see the tape 10 times, and I could see it coming 10 weeks ago. Billy Jack and the Oliver family have no love lost for each other, and they never have. When they got together, I told you a long time ago, and I told everybody, it wasn't going to last. How can you take those two men to trust each other after all the things that Rip Oliver has done to Billy Jack? And you know what? His little snot-nosed son was behind every darn thing that went down between those two.
Oh, he was not. I'm telling you.
I bet you his fat wife was in on it, too.
I'm really getting sick and tired of hearing your mouth of all these rumors, these lies. I know you're beginning to.
Billy Jack gave Rip's wife a free membership at his gym when it was open. You know what? You can see Rip Oliver with a wheelbarrow and an inner tube wheeling his wife in every day for 2 minutes and then taking her to the salad bar somewhere, sticking her up there for 20 minutes. Billy Jack told me her himself.
Oh, you know, right now, Billy Jack Haynes doesn't tell you about anything. Look at that move again by Little Beetlejuice. Took them both out of the play. Down to watch this. Clothesline by Big Juice. Clothesline by Little Juice. And Madril and Scotty the Body, you see his foot up there, are out of there. This, by the way, tonight, right now, is for the title. The Juicers are putting their tag team belts on the line.
And you can tell that Scotty the Body and Al Madril, they've got things under control. The Juicers are getting way above their adrenaline level, and Scotty the Body and Al Madril just simply cooling them down. They're going to take them down to earth temperature, because the Juicers, let's face it, you know, they've got the little girl in the hospital with the coma that's behind them, and they've got all these fans behind them. So Scotty the Body and Al Madril are taking on
six people at one time. They're taking on a whole building, and they're faring real well. I predict we're going to have new tag team champions tonight.
Well, that remains to be seen, but this is now a title championship match, and best two out of three. Now, that's important. It's best two out of three, and the Juicers are fighting for little Sarah Shuey. 8 years old, she's in Emmanuel Hospital in a coma, and the only thing that she's responding to is the day-old song and the Beetlejuicers. And that is an incredible story in itself right there. So they're fighting for little Sarah tonight. And I'm telling you, this whole place is just coming unglued.
Let me explain about that little girl in the coma. I have sympathy for everybody, but you know something? When I was 5 years old and I was crossing the street, my mother got run over by a milk truck. And the man got out, you know what he said to me? He said, "I'm sorry," when my mother laid there. So that's my sympathy for everybody here. I'm not gonna go out and feel sorry for anybody. I hope the girl comes back to life, but don't expect me to be sending her cards and everything. If you people wanna support the Beetlejuicers, get something realistic behind you.
Boy, you are really something else. I can't believe I'm even sitting here
hey,
next
hey,
to you
hey,
listening
nobody
to
gave
garbage.
Me nothing all my life. I've had to scrape for everything I've ever had.
Yeah.
I may have money now, but let me tell you something. Everybody's always got to count the odds against me and try and stack on me, and I've overcome them every time. And you want to know something else? Everybody's starting to forget about Jonathan Holliday because he's got the pins in his arms and everything. Well, I got a big surprise for all you people when I get these pins out of my arm. You want to go ahead and make your notes and poke fun at me? That's fine, because everybody else did it at one time or another, and everybody else ended up in Singapore Sam's underneath the hospital ward.
Hey, what? Yeah, I know the pins in your arm are pretty bad. What about the marbles in your head? Jeez. All right.
You know Beatles. Something, Koss? I'll bet when you cross your heart, you must use an O.
Jeez. Beetlejuice working on Scotty the Body. And I'll tell you, we got action here tonight. We're going to have action next Saturday night. And starting Monday, the 16th, in Roseburg at the Fairgrounds, 8 o'clock bell time. Hold on. Let's see if we got a pin here. One, two. Did he got it.
I go.
What? I can't believe it.
We have new champions.
No, this is best two out of three.
Oh, no, we have new champions.
Two out of three, and Scotty and Al Madril have taken the first fall.
We've got new champions.
Another shocker here. We'll be right back with more after this.
An old-fashioned barn-raising style project will turn Westland Cedar Oak Park School Playground into a structure the children call the Playground of Dreams. It was designed from the imaginations of children, and from April 25th through 29th, volunteers will make it a reality. People of all ages can take part. Your help will make a difference. Hot meals and daycare will be provided. KPTV and our Time to Care sponsors urge you to give a few hours to help make the Playground of Dreams come true.
If you can't catch the 10 o'clock news every night, NewsWatch recaps the top stories that made news in the Northwest every Sunday night at 10:30 on KPTV 12.
Next Saturday night, ladies and gentlemen, again, a reminder, the drawing is going on all night tonight for our tournament next Saturday night to determine the Pacific Northwest heavyweight champion. And we are drawing names to determine the opponents, and Billy Jack Haynes just drew the name of Larry Oliver. What's the matter with you?
I think your pacemaker's going to blow out or something.
Oh, can you get out of here? We're going to go back to the ring. Boy, I tell you, why are they letting her up here in charge of the hat?
Team champions, one more, baby. Let's do it.
All right, now we're into our second fall now of what has turned out to be a title match here.
Could you believe that? Larry Oliver and Billy Jack next Saturday right here. You know, it just never stops. This is better than Christmas. Every time I open up a new present, something I want comes out.
Well, I can't keep track of all the things that are happening tonight. I mean, it's just it's a wave of like shock therapy all over the place tonight. Billy Jack Haynes. We've got the tournament
thing
going.
It's like nitro and glycerin, you know what? And every time we get here, when Billy Jack sits down, it's nitro and glycerin, baby. We're going to explode.
We got the tournament going on, and starting next Saturday night, we're drawing names for the opponents for that tournament tonight. Well, now we've got a tag team championship going on. Last minute change. Best two out of three, the Juicers against the team of Madril and Scotty the Body. My word, what in the world? We've also got on Saturday the 28th, mark this down, Saturday the 28th right here at the House of Action, kids free when accompanied by a paying adult. And look what's happening during the week,
you know,
Jonathan Holliday.
Before we get in there, I wanted to compliment you on your suit, you know. That must have cost you two installments and a change of address.
Are you sure you haven't been reading Scotty the Body's handbook on personal insults and put downs?
Let me give you something straight. He's never come up with anything on his own since I've been here.
All right, Monday.
Every line I use in the bar, he's got a copy.
Why don't you go with what we got here? What our people just told me, the camera people, said that when TaylorMade Medina had my attention distracted, she was in the way. She was blocking off my view of Billy. I understand that Billy Jack Haynes was handpicking those names out of the hat. He handpicked Larry Oliver's name. Did you see that?
Whoa!
We got it all happening in the middle of the ring right now. There's so much confusion going on.
If I'm not mistaken, Scotty the Body and Al Madril just won the second fall.
We're all even. We're even. One fall apiece. Let's get out of here. Be right back right after this.
Freak out. Megawatt versus the Vampires of the Sun is here. It's 48 pages of full-color glossy action for kids between the ages of 8 and 80. And just like the Macho Man's career, it can only get bigger and better with your support. Yeah, this campaign starts at 48 pages, but Megawatt versus the Vampires of the Sun gets larger with more great fans like you, Maggie. That's right, it takes you to make this comic book's page count grow until it's unstoppable. All the way to 80 pages of glow-in-the-dark vampiric insanity. Yeah, Hulk Hogan, did you hear that? And don't forget, there are surprises around every corner of this campaign, like trading cards, magnets, posters, and more. And for those of you who help make Megawatt vs. the Vampires of the Sun a raging success by sharing this campaign with your friends, there are even more special treats waiting for you when the campaign closes. I'm talking about ultra-rare blank sketch covers for free and a whole lot more. And don't you worry, Mom and Dad. This is a spooky book safe for kids, but with a story that'll keep you guessing what happens next, too. It's Megawatt versus the Vampires of the Sun, Book 1, awaiting your approval on Indiegogo. Snap into that website. Ooh, yeah. Dig it!
You're going to draw a name, you're going to cry about losing that second fall.
Of course, he pulled it tight, but I'll tell you what. Everyone's up here expecting me to pull a name, but I'll tell you what. I'm the television champion. I get first shot at the winner. I don't have to enter the tournament. I'm automatically facing the winner as soon as the tournament's over, so I'm not going to take a chance of getting beat and getting bumped out. I'm already facing the winner, pal.
Wait, are these your own rules? Huh? Is he making up his own rules again? Larry, you saw what happened up here just moments ago. Billy Jack Haynes came up here. I did not know at the time you were distracting me. I knew you were distracting me, but I had no idea what was going on. Billy Jack Haynes actually handpicked your name out of that hat.
I don't know what's going on. All I know is that my dad just left for the hospital. I don't know nothing about Billy Jack. I don't really care right now. All I know is that my dad's the most important thing right now, and I just, I'm really confused.
Yes, he is. And as soon as we get a report back on the condition of your dad, we'll certainly let everybody know. But Larry Oliver, come on. Can you just kind of leave us alone? Come on. We don't have time for you or room for you tonight. Larry, next Saturday night, the fight of your life, Billy Jack Haynes has picked your name out of the hat.
Well, I don't know, It's still, like I said, I'm worried about my dad. I'm not really worried about next Saturday night, And all I know is that I'm just really confused.
You know what? He's not confused, cause. Come on, let's get real. He looks like Baby Huey there. And I'll tell you what, Baby Huey is not confused. I think the optimum word here is a chicken. Baby Huey, you're a chicken, pal. You're scared of Billy Jack Haynes.
Wow! Wow, man! Well, he asked for it.
I'll tell you one thing, Scott. I'm not afraid of you. I'm not afraid of Billy Jack. And I'll be here next Saturday, not for you, not for anyone else, but for my dad. And I'm going to show him that I'm not afraid of anyone, Scotty the Body.
All right, he's going to be fighting for two. All right, let's get out of here before anything else. We'll be right back. Let's get out. Huh?
Hey, he's lucky he ran off, of course. But I'll tell you what, looks like something better stayed. Right?
Flying up. Oh, she slapped your
boss. I like when women do that.
Hey, come. Final fall now of our championship match, tag team match, the Juicers against Madril. And Scotty the Body, Ricky Santana up here to draw a name.
Well, I've already drawn the name. The name's been drawn. Al Madril, let me tell you something. You are going to be the stepping stone for me to become the Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Champion. Madril, beat me if you can.
All right, Ricky Santana, Al Madril, that's all part of our tournament next Saturday night. I can't believe it. Now, mark this down. You got to get your tickets for next Saturday night. We're going to have our Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Championship tournament. We're drawing names tonight to determine who's going to be involved opponent by opponent next Saturday night. And we're going to keep on going until we have a new Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Champion. It's coming down next Saturday night. By the way, later on in the month of April, the 22nd, we're going to be in Umatilla at the high school as you watch the action continue out here in our third and final fall of our championship match. Monday the 23rd in Lapine at the high school. And the winners and still champions, ladies and gentlemen, the Beetlejuicers. You saw it right there. Little Juice, Big Juice, and their fallen opponents, Al Madril and Scotty the Body, and Ricky Santana back here again.
Yeah, let me tell you something. You know, I want to represent the Northwest. I have before. I'm going to do it again. Madril, let me tell you something. You're going to be in for the fight of your life. I guarantee you, I'm not going to let nobody down. I am going to be the next Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Champion.
This is fresh meat. Where did we get him?
Oh, come on. You're getting a little stale.
Who is he? Where did we get him?
All right. Let's get Bill Francis.
You are handsome.
Come on. Will you just get out of here? Bill Francis, have you drawn a name?
Don, I'm going to be wrestling Rip Oliver. And I know what's happening to Rip tonight. And I wish him well. But Rip will be the first one to say there's only going to be one man walking out of that ring. I wish him well, this is for the marbles, and I'm going to do my best. Rip, be ready, brother.
All right, Rip Oliver, as you know right now. All right, here we got the Beetlejuicers.
Hey, it's showtime, baby. Dale, Sarah, Shuey, we did it for you. We dedicate that to you, and we did it. Now I get to pick who I get to wrestle next week in the tournament.
All right, who you got?
I got Big Juice.
You got Big Juice?
I got to wrestle you, man, Saturday night.
Oh, come on. Is that right?
I got to wrestle you. We're the champions. I got to wrestle you.
Okay, all right. It's going to be Juice against Juice. We got Brian Adams. Brian, come on in here.
Get out of here. It's the big man's interview time. Curtis Thompson, you are the most unluckiest person in the world. You drew the big daddy here. Next Saturday night, it's not going to be pretty.
All right, Equalizer.
Hey, I'm glad to wrestle Superstar. I don't care nothing about, you know, the belt or anything. I just want to get it on the ring and hurt somebody.
Hey, let me tell you something, you big idiot. Hey, you're wrestling me, boy. I'll tell you something. I'm going to do something about this. You're part of the wrecking crew. You shouldn't be wrestling me. I'll tell you what. You better keep your hands off of me.
You better not stop.
All right, we got to get out of here. Next Saturday night, the Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Championship Tournament. You be here. Don't miss it. Get your tickets early. We'll see you next Saturday night. Hey.